Welcome back to another episode, and I think you're really gonna like this one. I'm taking a bunch of scrap metal and turning it into a finished functioning part all in one video. What I'm about to show you is part of a larger project that I've been working on for about 4 or 5 years now. I'm currently building a very powerful light engine with a very high CRI. The experimental chip that I'm using creates so much light and so much heat in such a small package, it was a thermal engineering challenge to make this work. It was such a challenge that this chip has never been ran full power before for more than a few seconds. I'm hoping to change that. I'm gonna show you the entire process, how I design it, how I build it, how I machine it, the whole thing. The only thing I can't show you is the actual chip that I'm using since it is in the experimental stage. May sound crazy, but let's go. This right here is a solid piece of AR06 12 micron graphite. It looks like it's all done machining and there's conductive carbon dust everywhere. But let's clean the part off, see how it looks. Here's the finished mold, came out pretty good. You're looking at 10 hours of straight machining right here, and it came out so pretty that I'm really regretting using the one piece of graphite. It was all chipped up, because other than that, it came out absolutely perfect. One thing about this graphite, watch this. This is a table that's about 25 feet away from the milling machine. And even though I was using an extractor, the dust is just so fine, it gets everywhere. Now comes the tricky part to try and cast it. Now I need to know how much copper to put in my crucible. And to figure that out quickly, I'm gonna jump back in Fusion 360, hit inspect, click on the bottom of my cavities. That's gonna give me the surface area of the bottom of my cavities. I'm gonna multiply that times the height. That's gonna give me my volume. Now I know that copper has a density of 8.96 grams per cubic centimeter. So from there I can figure out what the weight of the copper that I'm putting in the crucible should be.
9 pounds.
This is the amount of copper that I need to make the part. Sure seems like a lot, but numbers don't lie.
Oh yeah, that sucker's hot. Whoa, that's heavy. I don't care if it's too messy. I just want it completely full. This is what I got here. A little bit rough around the edges, looks pretty ugly, but I think it'll finish up real nice. Better than I expected. And this here is the finished part. I think it came out really nice overall. I do want to mention that this isn't the first part that I show being machined earlier in the video. This is actually the third casting. I had to recast the first one because I had some separation marks in between the first and the second pour. And then the second one that I cast, which came out better than the first, was damaged when I broke a drill bit in one of these holes, and then I broke a tap in another one of these holes. The entire process was a nightmare three times over. It's like 10 degrees outside and I am pouring sweat. The only good thing was that every time I recast it and remachined it, it came out better and better, and this is the third one, and I think it looks pretty good. Coming out pretty good so far, and the way I originally designed this is to accommodate a sheet metal enclosure that bolts onto the front of this and hides everything inside. But for now I want to see everything working inside, so I'm gonna get this chip mounted, bolt this to the table temporarily, fire this thing up, and after all this hard work, see if it actually works. It's almost there, but I'm gonna tilt this up to let the rest of the air out and speed things up. The water block is completely full with coolant, and now the final step, the moment of truth, to test it. The entire goal of this project is to run this chip at full power, which hasn't been done before, while keeping the temperature of the chip under 140 degrees Fahrenheit, around 60 degrees Celsius. I got everything all set up. I have my thermometer right here on the chip. I got the infrared camera set up. Let's do it. All right, here we go. 25% power. 50% power. 75. And 100. That right there is full power. See some smoke coming off the face of the water block, but that might just be my wires heating up. 110 degrees. I'm just gonna wait for the temperature in the entire system to equalize, see what it tops out at. And just to show you how bright this light actually is, I'm gonna look away and I'm gonna put my hand in front of it. Check this out. That's like so bright I can't even look at my hand. It's really hard to convey on camera how bright this light is, but it's intense. It looks like that's where it's gonna stay, about 122 degrees Fahrenheit. That looks good to me. I thought it was gonna hit about 125, but it looks like an equalized there. It's about 70 degrees ambient temperature.
Well, it looks like my temperature didn't exceed 125 degrees. That was my goal and I achieved it. And this wouldn't be a finished video unless I did one high speed clip lighting it up with this light. It's not gonna be perfect because this isn't done, but at least it'll give you an idea of the quality of light that this chip makes. Check it out.
Down in a city's hollow, we fool around with the shadows, each other slowly biting outside. The red sun is rising.
That was extremely satisfying that this actually worked. There was a lot of iterations of this to get to this point. My main challenge here was to be able to remove the heat fast enough from the chip into the actual coolant. Sounds really simple, but it was actually very difficult to be able to get that much heat transferred in such a small surface area. This has been a nightmare. Taking scrap copper and turning it into a finished part was no easy feat.
The hardest part for me was casting, because copper, it's not an easy metal to cast. It ends up absorbing a lot of the air molecules into the liquid copper. And then what happens is when the copper solidifies, that air tries to get out and it creates aeration in the casting, which is all those little air pockets that you see. The only way I got over that was by using a different technique. I put a lot of flux into my crucible first, heated it up, waited till the flux was melted, and then added the copper. So as the copper transitioned from a solid phase into a liquid phase, the flux was the barrier in between that transition and protected that molten metal from the air. All the way up until the pot was full, then I poured it and I got a clean casting, which I was very surprised, because those were large parts. That's all I got for you in this one. Hopefully you enjoyed that episode. I hope it was inspiring or at least entertaining, but tell me what you think in the comments below and look out for some future episodes where I use this light. Adios.
Oh, that was only the top. Sort of off. I don't know what happened there. I completely cut the top off and I'm definitely not eating that piece because, yeah, it's kind of, well, I guess I could wash it off. 2, 1. Oh, I got that one. I finally got a useful Christmas present. So let me open up these knives and see if they're any good. So let me open up these knives and see if they're any good. Kami Koto. Say Honolulu? Oh no. Japan. Yeah, Japan. There we go. Mumbo jumbo. Definitely cut my finger. I like this one the best.